is the next thing. You've mentioned 70%. Now, a lot of people will come and say, Samanika, I don't even have 70%. Maine to abhi, I've just entered my second year or third year or fourth year and I haven't had the opportunity of doing any kind of corporate internship so far. What do I do? Right? How do I make this 70-30 ratio? My suggestion to you would be start writing articles, okay? Because articles is one way where you are able to communicate to the other person that, yes, I'm aware of this particular subject, right? Even if you've done an internship or not. In college, you might have written a lot of papers, like 50 subjects padhte hain, 50 subjects mein 50 research papers likhte hain, right? You can talk about that during my, in my third semester, I've done a research on so-and-so particular topic. Right? You have to give the indication to the other person that yes, you have studied this law or yes, you've worked on this. You might have done a moot court, chahe wo internal moot court mein hi kyun nahi aapne kaam kiya, right? But if you've done anything, mention that in your CV. Lot of people have this thing in their mind that, ma'am, maine wo kiya to hai, but kya mujhe wo likhna chahiye? Mujhe kisi ne bola nahi. See, your CV is your CV. It is your identity. Okay, whatever way you want to represent yourself. Do not think about rat race. Ki janta kya kar rahi hai, majority janta. Because if you end up doing what everybody else is doing, then your application will also get rejected the way their application is getting rejected, right? So you have to add your own flavor. There used to be a psychologist I met last year. He used to say ki when you apply for SSB, sabki psychology application se kuch na kuch ek fresh khushbu aati hai. Kisi ka ek फ्लेवर आता है खट्टे का, किसी का मीठे का, किसी का सार का, किसी का जो भी, वट एवर सॉल्टी, वट एवर यू वॉन्ट टू से, राइट? सो इन द सेम मैनर योर सीवी गिव्स अ फ्लेवर अबाउट योर पर्सनैलिटी. ओके, सो यू कैन ऐड एनी थिंग विच इज रेलिवेंट टू दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट, बिकॉज ऑफ विच यू कैन शो इट टू द अदर पर्सन दैट येस, आई एम सिंसियर एंड आई एम जेन्युइनली इंटरेस्टेड. बोलने को सब बोलते हैं थर्ड ईयर में दैट आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन कॉप लॉ. उनको ये भी नहीं पता होता कि कॉर्पोरेट में आता क्या क्या, राइट? तो अगर आप भी वो कर रहे हो या फिर आप सामने वाले को बोल रहे हो कि मैम, आई हैव स्टडीड कंपनीज एक्ट इन माय थर्ड ईयर एंड आई जेन्युइनली एंजॉयड द टॉपिक ऑफ मर्जर्स एंड एक्विजिशन और कैपिटल मार्केट और वट एवर यू स्टडीड इन योर कॉप लॉ सब्जेक्ट्स, राइट? एंड देयरफॉर आई डेवलप्ड एन इंटरेस्ट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट. सो योर एप्लीकेशन विल साउंड मोर सिंसियर, राइट? सो दैट इज द थिंग यू हैव टू रिफ्लेक्ट इन योर एप्लीकेशन. लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट वन, पब्लिकेशंस. नाउ फर्स्ट थिंग, यू हैव स्पोकन अबाउट योर एकेडमिक रिकॉर्ड्स, right? On top, then you spoke about your skill sets, which you can offer in LawSeeCo. Like we have our own CV format where whatever skill sets students have learned, like I'll just show you what are the different kinds of skill sets they write. Now, you may not be a LawSeeCo student, but this hack will help you also. So what you do is you open LawSeeCo ka website. Okay. Now you check any particular course. Say you are interested in, go to courses and say you are applying for an IPR internship. Okay. Check which is the course related to IPR. Just type IPR in the search box, right? Now you see this course, okay? Just open it. Then do a control F and search for specific learning. This page will give you a list of the skill sets which IPR lawyers have, like what are the different kinds of work they do, right? तो सबसे पहले स्टॉकिंग स्किल्स के लिए सबसे सही प्लेटफॉर्म है ये, क्योंकि इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ वेदर आई एम वर्किंग इवन आई एम वर्किंग एट LawSeeCo, बट अदरवाइज ऑल्सो आई वुड से कि स्टॉकिंग के लिए सबसे सही चीज है, बिकॉज हम इंटर्नशिप में जाते हैं और हमें कई बार पता भी नहीं होता कि वहाँ कैसा काम होता है, क्या काम करते हैं, राइट? तो दिस विल गिव यू द फ्री इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट दैट. इन दिस स्पेसिफिक लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव, ये उन लोगों के लिए जो स्मार्ट वर्क करते हैं, नॉट द हार्ड वर्क. लाइक जो हार्ड वर्क करते हैं वो पूरा गूगल करके, पूरा सब्जेक्ट पढ़ के सब कुछ करते हैं, डिटेल्स करते हैं, इंटरव्यू लेते हैं लोगों का, बट जो स्मार्ट वर्क करते हैं वो यहाँ पे आके सीधे चुपचाप ये चीजें देख सकते हैं. 20-25 पॉइंट्स में लिस्टेड है, ठीक है? So these are the different kinds of work the IPR lawyers are doing, right? Prosecution of infringement of IP, how to do IP due diligence, how to deal with copyright, वगैरह वगैरह. Now if you've done any kind of work related to this, okay, or if you've studied any kind of this thing in your IPR class, mention that in your CV, like, or in your cover note that during my IPR class, for example, just in case your teacher taught you about valuation of intellectual property, okay, just giving you an example, or anything out of these things, or how to draft a patent application, you can say that during my IPR subject in my third year, I learned how to draft a patent application and therefore I built interest in my IPR laws, right? So that will give a more genuine, sincere vibe about your profile. In the same manner, so these are the skill sets LawSeeCo students write in their CV, like above their internship they say that, like, I know how to draft this, I know how to do this, like ye cheez ye sara jo hai, how to draft a draft and file a passing off suit and all. There's something called this thing, list of weekly exercises also. So from here also, if you've done anything, you could be a working professional working in this particular sector. Okay, I'm just giving you example for IPR. You can check all the 44 plus courses which are there on the website. Could be M&A, could be drafting, could be contract management, could be technology, whatever. Just open that course. Weekly exercises में से देखो आपने इसमें से क्या-क्या किया है. ठीक है. एंड ऑन द स्किल सेट्स पार्ट टॉक अबाउट दैट. फॉर एग्जांपल दिस इज द क्लास यू गाइस विल बी गेटिंग फॉर फ्री. नाउ नेक्स्ट टाइम इन योर सीवी यू कैन से दैट लाइक इन द स्किल सेट्स आई नो हाउ टू ड्राफ्ट अ म्यूजिक लाइसेंस अग्रीमेंट. इफ यू ऑलरेडी नो से सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपमेंट अग्रीमेंट और फ्रेंचाइजी अग्रीमेंट और व्हाटएवर यू रिटन राइट. सो दैट विल गिव अ बेटर इंप्रेशन अबाउट यू दैट येस दिस पर्सन कैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू आर प्रैक्टिस इन दिस मैनर. नाउ उससे क्या होता है कि वेन यू टेल द अदर पर्सन सर मुझे ये चीज ऑलरेडी आती है वो क्या करेंगे आपसे उसी से रिलेटेड काम करवाएंगे रादर देन गिविंग यू एनी काइंड ऑफ ancillary work because mostly third and fourth year students jinko big firms mein internship mil bhi jati hai the only complaint they have is ma'am mujhe to kuch productive kaam mila hi nahi mujhe bas photocopy ka kaam mila ya filing ka kaam mila right. So if you tell the other person that ma'am I already so for example when I was working in HSA in my 6th or 9th month I drafted my first operations and management contract right as an associate. Now imagine if you are joining the organization as an intern and on the first day you are telling the partner that sir I already know how to draft an operations and management contract, please let me know how can I help you. Do you think he'll not give you the quality work and rather give you ancillary work, ye print out kar do ya ye photocopy kar do, right? So that is the kind of impression you want to have. Isliye jo bhi aapko aata hai wherever you are right now, ठीक है. आई एम नॉट सेइंग ये करो वो मत करो वो करो वो मत करो. अभी जो भी आता है उसके बेसिस पे थिंक अबाउट द थिंग्स यू हैव डन. ओके. एंड देन लिस्ट आउट द स्किल सेट्स यू ऑलरेडी हैव. कुछ ना कुछ डेफिनेटली होगा ही होगा. आपने अभी तक जरूर सीखा होगा स्पेशली इफ यू आर इन सेकंड ईयर एंड अबव. ओके. नाउ पब्लिकेशंस मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. यू शुड हैव पब्लिकेशंस बिकॉज पब्लिकेशन से यू आर एबल टू जस्टिफाई टू द अदर पर्सन दैट नॉट ओनली एम आई इंटरेस्टेड इन दैट सब्जेक्ट आई एम ऑल्सो अवेयर ऑफ लाइक आई हैव नॉलेज ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट एंड वी कैन एंगेज इन टू अ कॉन्वर्जेशन अबाउट दिस. अगर आप बोलते हो कि आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन IPR ठीक है देन the person can ask you questions from anywhere like acha batao why are you interested in IPR okay tell me about this deal or tell me about that or are you aware of this patent wagera wagera can ask you anything right. At the same time if you've written about any particular subject as a publication within that particular IPR domain then the topic of conversation would not be any random topic from the field of IPR rather from that particular topic which you are mentioning in your CV that I have done a research in this particular topic right. For example COVID related you can write that COVID vaccine whether it should get the IPR rights or not whoever is producing it right. So then they will talk about that क्योंकि आप उनको एक टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन देते हो. देखो दो तरीके के इंटरव्यू होते हैं. एक वो इंटरव्यू होता है जिसमें इंटरव्यूअर आपका इंटरव्यू ले रहा होता है राइट. एंड जो दूसरा तरीका होता है वो होता है जिसमें आप इंटरव्यू लीड कर रहे हो. तो मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स हू सिक्योर एंड सिक्योर द अपॉर्चुनिटी आर द वंस हू एक्चुअली रन द इंटरव्यू. लाइक व्हेन आई केम आउट ऑफ माय प्लेसमेंट इंटरव्यू कैंपस प्लेसमेंट माय फ्रेंड्स वर लाफिंग एंड दे वर लाइक did you take his interview or did he take your interview because when I told them that this was the conversation because at every single step when I was giving him one particular answer I knew what would be the follow up question right. So that is how that is the kind of tricks I want you guys to learn. This is exactly what I tell my students when they go for mock interviews that when you are going for a mock interview make sure you give them very specific statements so that next question wahi se flow karega. For example in my interview I'll give you another example. In my JAG interview the interviewing officer asked me Samanika you come from corporate background in army we don't want corporate lawyers now why would you be interested in joining us and I just smiled and I said sir we've studied 50 subjects in law school but we have been trained in such a manner that we can practice in 50 more like for example a lot of new subjects are coming like space law sports law cyber law and all that so I can like tomorrow even though I have not studied these subjects in college I can any day practice these right. And then he told me okay fine now because I mentioned these three subjects he couldn't have asked me aviation law right. He asked me from those particular topics only so he told me okay tell me anything about cyber law like whatever you are aware of. So because I had students from cyber law courses and I used to regularly mentor them so luckily I was aware of few things related to that particular subject and also like just before entering my SSB hall I had checked what was the current news so usse SSB se just 2 din pehle hi rice summit hua tha jisme PM Modi was there and there were few important discussions which happened so I told them that like sir during rice summit also these were the things which was discussed cyber law mein ye hota hai wagera wagera. Now I knew that the interviewing officer wasn't from legal background so for him he was convinced enough right that whatever I'm claiming to know yes I'm aware of it right? So that's how your interview should be, that you should be leading your interview, that whatever you say, that this is what I know, then you can engage the other person into that particular kind of conversation. Now in publications, therefore, like, we have our article writing team mentors who help law school students in writing, in choosing their topic. Because students kya karte hain, bahut aap log kya karte hain, bahut vague topic le loge. Jaise for example, mergers and acquisitions in India. Now this is one topic, ispe puri book likhi ja sakti, and you want to cover it in 3000 words or 4000 words, right? So therefore our mentors help you in like selecting your topic, streamlining it, and then structuring. And then after that, when you discuss it with your interviewer or during your internship also, that, sir, I have written a, like, for example, when Aadhaar came, okay, at that point of time, whoever was interning, if they would have gone to their senior and said, sir, this is the paper I've written on Aadhaar, could you kindly share your feedback? And a lot of law firms were getting questions related to Aadhaar, right? So then it becomes more convenient for you and easier for you to impress the other person that, yes, this person knows the law and the substance of it and not just trying to fake it. Now, for people who have more than 10-15 publications, please do not write everything in your CV. Isi wajah se aapka CV do pages se zyada badhta hai, right? Mention top 4 or top 5 max. Theek hai? Uske alawa, even if you've done, say, 25 publications. So those top 5 should be recent ones or related to that particular subject you're applying for. Agar aap M&A mein apply kar rahe ho, then do not talk about your IPR publications if you have M&A specific publications. Okay, because then you confuse the other person. Ki aap top pe bol rahe ho, I am interested in mergers and acquisition, but publications you are talking about IPR, then internship aapne kari hai, litigation, like what exactly are you looking for, right? So when you are streamlining your CV, you have to give that impression that, yes, I am interested in M&A. These are the skill sets I have related to M&A, and these are the publications I have related to M&A. Okay, but just in case you don't have, then talk about the recent ones, like recent issues on which you have written about. And remaining 20, jo hai, you can say that additionally written, last, add one more point saying additionally written 20 plus papers on topics related to arbitration, criminal law, family law, whatever laws you've written, right? Which was not relevant to that particular organization. So that you are able to convey ki, haan bhaiya, maine 25 se zyada publications kari hai. At the same time, you are not filling more than 2 pages of your CV, right? Your CV is still like giving that 70-30 impression, okay? Now you can provide hyperlinks. Do not give the full URL link. Wo aapka space khayega. Hyperlinks isliye kyunki if you are applying for virtual internships, and these days post-COVID, most of the people are taking virtual interns. So at that point of time, it will become easier for you to help them navigate and read the post online. Check karne ke liye, cross-check karne ke liye. For example, NUJS has this online blog called JILS. Now the blog publishes a lot of smaller articles online, right? So if you've given the link, the recruiter can just click on the hyperlink and navigate to that page and check what kind of research work or what kind of articles do you write. Okay. Yeah. So if you've done different publications, the same point, if there are several other publications mentioned in a separate heading, like published X number of articles on other areas of law, like constitutional law, real estate law, whatever, right? This is the example. Paper publication, you've mentioned the details, you've mentioned where is it published and on what date, right? Ye cheeze aapko first year mein legal methods ki class mein sikhaya hoga, usko kaise cite karna hai, so I'll not go into those details. Next comes your moot court experience. Same policy applies there also, that you talk about reverse chronological order, jo recent moot court ke hai, wo top mein baat karo, theek hai? Definitely talk about what kind of role you had. Okay, because if you think from the point of view of psychology, now if you tell me that you've been a researcher in that particular team, then I'll think that, okay, fine, if I'm looking for a junior who can help me with the research, this person would be a good fit. Okay, moot courts aapka wahin pe sabse zyada kaam aata hai, because aaj se 7 years down the line, people, recruiters were not interested in Indian law students who were doing a lot of moot courts, because moot court practice and practical field mein jo practice hoti hai, wo bahut alag hoti hai. But at present, the current generation of partners, most of them are themselves judging moot court competitions, and they have themselves been a part of their college moot court teams. So they are accepting students who are doing moot courts, because it gives two impressions. First is, aap college mein keval academics mein aapne focus nahi kiya, aapne extracurricular activities bhi kari hai. दूसरा चीज, लॉ फर्म्स में दे डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू हायर रोबोट्स जो केवल कट थ्रोट काम करते हैं कि अपने काम से मतलब है. दे एक्चुअली want team players, right? So if you've done a moot court, it will give a very good impression that yes, this person is a team player. And law firm mein agar ek koi bahut bada due diligence karna hoga, jo 700 pages ki report jiski banni hogi, to usme the parts are divided amongst the team members, right? So if I give that kind of task to you, you will be able to work together with the team and not try to say ki maine hi kiya hai, and not try to say that like the other person is not working, right? So wo differences na ho, that gives a very good impression that if you've done a moot court, irrespective of whether you won it or not, right? As a team player, from the point of view of psychology, I'm saying. Secondly, if you've been a speaker, of course, if you are a speaker, law firms mein aapko bahut zyada presentations deni hoti hai clients ko, aapko regularly client meetings karni hoti hai, apne seniors ko brief karna hota hai, to un sab ke liye it gives a very good impression. Okay, so do not forget to mention about your moot court experience. If you haven't done it, that's completely okay. Aisa nahi hai ki aapka bahut zyada negative point ho jayega. Ha, if you haven't done it, if you still have the option, go ahead, do a few moot court experience, moot court competition, because it's an amazing experience. And secondly, if you won an award, do mention about it, because that shows that yes, your memorial had strong value in terms of research and like whatever numbers you've got, that's why you might have got the prize, like first prize, second prize, runner-up prize, whatever, right? So like this girl has written researcher bracket second runner-up at the law college, this thing, NCR moot court competition held in New Delhi on so and so day. She's given all specific details, right? So are you guys able to understand like the amount of polishing you have to do? Everybody makes their CV, but there are very few people who go into that much depth, right? This is the amount of specifications you have to talk about in your CV. That agar moot court bhi bola to keval moot court ka naam nahi de diya. She's mentioned what place the competition was held at and on what date, so that if somebody wants to cross check and cross verify, they can do that, right? Next is position of responsibilities held. This is another important thing, gives a good impression about you. So isliye jin logon ne 5 saal law school mein kuch nahi kiya hai, please go back to your school days and think about the responsibilities you held there. Had you been a sports captain, school captain, prefect, whatever designations which were there, if you've been a part of it, please mention that, because it gives a very good impression that yes, this person is a responsibility holder. For example, in my case, what had happened was both my seniors had their personal emergencies and they were not available in the office, and we had to give a very important presentation to the client. So I was the only person available in the office, and because they felt that I could hold responsibility, I was given the responsibility that in their absence I have to prepare the entire presentation, and if they are not able to return before we have to present, then I will only have to present it before the client, right? So my senior returned just one day before the presentation, and my entire presentation was ready, my entire script was ready, and I was able to save them, right? So in the same manner, if you've held any kind of responsibility, if you've been a responsibility holder in the past, do mention that in your CV. Lastly, additional courses. See, this is one thing I do not recommend. Okay, even if you're doing one course and you're making best value out of it, only then you mention that. Don't try to do 10 number of courses, because during lockdown, Coursera, there's this what is that platform, Coursera, something like that, I am forgetting the name actually, was offering free courses. So a lot of you went to do that. WIPO, the World Intellectual Property Organization, a lot of you have done its IPR course, and you mentioned 10 courses in your CV, and then anybody who comes to me says I've done this intellectual property right course from WIPO, I just ask them few things related to the practical knowledge of IPR, that are you even aware of this, or tell me basics, and their basics are not clear. Okay, so do not do any particular course just for the sake of a certificate. I had done so many of them, and in my final CV during my job interview, I did not even mention them. Trust me guys, I don't even have the certificates, or like even if I would have, I've never mentioned in my any of my job interviews or my CV, right? Only talk about those things which you are 100% aware of, where you can give 100% value to the other person, right? Always remember the ground rule, undercommit and overperform, rather than overcommitting and underperform. If you mention 10 additional certificate courses in your CV, it will not add any value. Rather, what you are trying to do is you are telling the other person, "Arey sir, mujhe to IPR bhi aata hai, mediation bhi aata hai, ADR bhi aata hai. Pooch lo question kahin se bhi pooch lo." एंड फिर जब वो क्वेश्चन पूछने लगेंगे और आपको अगर आंसर्स नहीं आएंगे, आप खुद से अपने चांसेस रिड्यूस करोगे टू सिक्योर दैट पर्टिकुलर जॉब. ओके, नाउ लास्टली एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज, एंड इसके बाद एक और हेडिंग आती है हॉबीज. टू थिंग्स, ऑलवेज मेंशन देम, बिकॉज अदर देन अ वेरी फ्यू टियर वन फर्म्स विच आर ओनली लुकिंग फॉर पीपल हु कैन वर्क फॉर लाइक 12 to 14 hours. Most of the other firms in India and independent lawyers are not hiring robots. They are hiring humans. So they want to know that if you will be working with them as their future colleagues, will you be an interesting personality to work with or not? ओके सो दीज आर द थिंग्स लाइक अगर आपने ये एक्स्ट्रा करिकुलर एक्टिविटीज की होती है कई बार ऐसे हो जाता है इट हैज हैपेंड विद माय बैचमेट्स आल्सो लाइक दे मेंशन दैट वी प्ले फुटबॉल राइट एंड द अदर पर्सन वाज आल्सो अ फुटबॉल प्लेयर ड्यूरिंग हिज कॉलेज डेज सो लाइक 15 मिनट्स कॉन्वर्सेशन वाज ओनली अबाउट फुटबॉल एंड देन ही सिक्योर्ड द जॉब ऑफकोर्स नॉट ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ फुटबॉल बट अदर थिंग्स आल्सो बट दैट एडेड ब्राउनी पॉइंट्स फॉर दैट पर्सन राइट सो टू पर्सन कैन develop like can have common interest and you can have a conversation so agar kai baar aisa ho jata hai ki aapka interview bahut heavy gaya hai and nobody wants to end an interview on a heavier note right they always wanted to end on a calmer note on a cooler level right so this gives that kind of an opportunity ki acha theek hai kitna bhi heavy kyun na raha interview yahan pe you can cool down and like end things on a positive note राइट सो इफ यू डोंट हैव इट देन इट माइट बी पॉसिबल दैट अगर आपको इंटरव्यू में बहुत उन्होंने ग्रिल किया है सो यू माइट कम आउट एंड यू विल फील वेरी बैड यू विल फील वेरी डाउन बट इफ यू गिव देम अ गुड अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई हैव अ स्टूडेंट ही इज आई थिंक इन फर्स्ट और सेकेंड ईयर एंड व्हेन आई सॉ हिज सीवी ही हैड रिटन दैट ही वॉज अ पार्ट ऑफ अंडर 19 F1 रेस एंड ही रिप्रेजेंट्स इंडिया लाइक ही इज अ नेशनल प्लेयर लाइक ही कम्स इन हैज अ नेशनल रैंक ऑल्सो right so that becomes a very interesting topic to talk about in my cv I used to talk about that I love solving sudoku right so your extracurricular activities your list of hobbies would be unique right baki sab cheeze bhi aapne aur aapke friend ne agar same internships kari hai har jagah same classroom mein haath pakad pakad ke bhi gaye ho sath mein fir bhi your hobbies and extracurricular activities can differentiate two of you right So do mention them. अच्छा आप लोग आते हो बोल के मैम मेरी तो कोई हॉबी नहीं है मैं क्या लिखूं रीडिंग राइटिंग प्लेइंग क्रिकेट और कुकिंग ये चार हॉबीज से प्लीज बाहर निकलो क्योंकि ये आपका धर्मसिद्ध अधिकार है ठीक है इफ यू आर बॉर्न इन इंडिया प्लेइंग क्रिकेट एंड कुकिंग आर लाइक टू थिंग्स विच लाइक फैमिलीज प्रिज्यूम यू शुड नो बाय बर्थ राइट उसके बियॉन्ड लिख सकते हो कैसे कर सकते हो अगेन योर स्टॉकिंग स्किल्स एंड कहाँ से करोगे गूगल देवता राइट तो गूगल पे जाओ सिंपली सर्च व्हाट आर द लिस्ट ऑफ हॉबीज आई कैन मेंशन इन माय सीवी okay list of the list of hobbies we can mention in our cv it will give you more than 100 hobbies and just pick from there ki mujhe isme se kya kya cheeze pasand hai right and then mention your unique set of hobbies so that in itself will give your cv a unique flavor about who you are as a person we're talking about cover letter and how your application should give a better impression to the other person right now in your cover letter firstly do not attach a cover letter unless and until the other person has specifically asked you to okay because nobody has the time to download an additional document and go through it right most of the people these days are using their smartphones so rather utilize the mail body and write a cover note instead of a cover letter okay make sure your cover note is very specific but before writing a cover note make sure your subject of the email is very specific this I had covered in my day before's session as well and I'm mentioning it again here your subject line should be very specific because aap hr ke paas ek acha impression dalna cha rahe ho that yes I am a sincere and a diligent person and I am genuinely interested okay how do you do that instead of just saying internship application in your cover in your subject line what do you say is request for internship in the month of say January 2021 in the M&A team okay so that when the hr is shortlisting candidates unke liye easy hoga and she'll have a better impression about you over anybody else who's just written internship application and sent because then she has to do control F she has to list find out the people who had applied she has to make notes in her diary and then allot the internship right so that way when you write a specific subject line you get brownie points from the HR okay then in your cover note you make it very specific keep it to two paragraphs only you don't have to write an essay there first paragraph has to be very specific with respect to who you are your background like for example I am Astha a fourth year student from so and so college okay if you are a rank holder please mention that if you've had any specific achievement which you want to bring into the attention of that particular person mention that okay then you say that during lockdown I built like I read upon now if you've watched any kind of particular webinars on a particular पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट विच आर इंटरेस्टेड इन और केस लॉज और लाइक सबसे पहले तो होमवर्क करके जाना ना. होमवर्क क्या है कि जिसकी टीम में जिस फॉर्म में अप्लाई करो उनके बारे में पहले पढ़ो, ठीक है, ऑनलाइन गूगल पे. नाउ यू कैन से दैट ड्यूरिंग लॉकडाउन. और बेस्ट चीज आजकल रिसर्च के लिए मोर देन गूगल इज दैट पर्टिकुलर फर्म्स लिंक्डइन प्रोफाइल. ओके, बिकॉज लिंक्डइन पेज नॉट प्रोफाइल, द फर्म्स लिंक्डइन पेज, दे अपडेट ऑल द डिटेल्स रिलेटेड टू द रीसेंट ट्रांजैक्शंस दे आर डूइंग एवरीथिंग ऑन लिंक्डइन. Because of bar council rules, they can't advertise, so they are putting the details on LinkedIn. So just check those details, and then you can say that during lockdown, I had the opportunity to attend so and so. Like one of the partners would have done one of the webinars on any platform. Most of them would have done webinars with LawSeeCo only. So you can say that I had attended a SERS webinar and I developed keen interest in this particular subject. These are the things I learned. Okay. These are the things I'm already aware of, or you can say these are the things I learned during the session, or you can say that these are the skill sets I've already learned from XYZ course or whatever, right? Or during my moot court or during my college days, right? And therefore I have built. So basically what you're trying to do is you're trying to build a nexus as to why you chose a particular topic, a particular field of law, and why you should be given an opportunity. Because by writing all these details, you are telling the other person that I'm different from other people. Other people are saying, I'm interested in M&A. Please let me know if there is an opportunity in the M&A team of your firm. What you are saying is you are giving them a detailed reason that, yes, I've done some homework. I know some basic things about this particular subject, and therefore I should be given an opportunity, right? So just imagine that if you are the HR, which one would you pick? A person who's giving a specific information or a person who's just saying that give me an opportunity, right? You have the answer with you, right? So first paragraph about these things. Second paragraph, again, you can give further details. Like if you've been a LawSeeCo student, you guys already know this. I've told you n number of times that whatever sample exercises you are doing, which have been evaluated by the evaluators, attach them along with your CV. Say that these are the drafts which I've drafted and here is the sample. Okay, that will give another better impression that yes, they don't have to mentor you from scratch. Because guys, I'll repeat it again and again and again. I had said this in my previous session also. Internship is not your mentorship session. Okay, there is no particular mentor sitting there waiting for you to join them just to train you. Right? Internship is not the place of learning. It is the place of learning, performing and excelling. And 90% of the second half and just 10% of the first half, which is learning, right? 10% learning, 90% actually performing and excelling. Then only you can get a callback or a PPO or an extension, right? So therefore, you like give them the first hand impression that mujhe aapko scratch se nahi sikhana hai. I'm not a mentee who's coming here for the sake of learning things from you. I'm here to contribute to your practice. Okay, that is the kind of impression you should have in your mindset while applying. And then you think that what are the skill sets I can offer to the other person's practice, area of practice. So aap unka LinkedIn profile dekho, unka firm ka website dekho, what kind of work do they do, what kind of work that particular team or the partner has been doing or writing about in the recent past, and then you talk about those things. Then you make a specific cover note. Okay, so these are the things. It has to be crisp and professional. And then you say, like, if you need any further details, you may reach out to me at so and so, right? So max two paragraphs and just additional last one line where you say that, like, if given an opportunity, I'll be grateful, or I shall be grateful, vagera, whatever you want to say. Or if you say that, like, if you need any further details, vagera, vagera, you can have your own version, right? So do not pick a template from Google for CV or cover letter. Rather, sit down and create your own template. ओके, कवर लेटर के लिए हजारों बच्चे मेरे पास आते हैं, मैम प्लीज गिव मी अ कवर लेटर टेम्पलेट. ऑनेस्टली दिस इज अ वेरी बैड प्रैक्टिस. आई डू नॉट प्रेफर गिविंग कवर लेटर सैम्पल्स. रादर आई ऑलवेज से यू राइट योर कवर लेटर फर्स्ट एंड देन गेट इट रिव्यूड. सो इफ यू आर अ LawSeeCo स्टूडेंट वॉचिंग दिस, यू वुड ऑलरेडी नो दैट आई जनरली डोंट लाइक गिविंग कवर लेटर टेम्पलेट्स, बिकॉज वॉट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स डू इज दे जस्ट कॉपी पेस्ट, राइट? तो देन यू लूज दैट अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ गिविंग द फ्लेवर ऑफ योर ओन इंडिविजुअल पर्सनैलिटी, राइट? Okay, now most important thing, your cover letter is not a summary of your CV. Do not try to summarize everything which you've already written. Okay, your cover letter, in the CV, we were writing 70% IPR specific and 30% anything else, or 70% of the team you are interested in, 30% anything else. In your cover letter, you will be summarizing that 70%. Okay, so you will talk about, and in addition to that, any academic excellence award you hold. right? Position, whatever, right? But only with respect to that particular subject. Any paper you've written only with respect to that particular subject you're applying for. Then you give a better impression that yes, this is a person jisko pehle se ye cheeze aati hai, right?